As the sun set over the island of Giglio, Captain Francesco Schettino welcomed passengers aboard the Costa Concordia for their cruise around the Mediterranean. At 51, he was an experienced captain. That evening, he dined with a Costa-employed Moldavian dancer while his first officer took command. Before leaving port, he had promised his head waiter, who was from Giglio, that he would perform a sail-by salute of the island. The Costa Concordia had done a similar salute of Giglio 5 months beforehand, and all had gone smoothly. The second officer charted the new course, but the ship's charts didn't show the rocks in detail. At 9:34 p.m., Captain Schettino went to the bridge to take command. The dancer and the head waiter went with him. The ship was on autopilot, and the helmsman was on the lookout. Schettino ordered the helmsman to take manual control and set the Costa Concordia to a new course. Then Schettino picked up the phone and called a retired captain from Giglio and asked if it was safe to sail by. Satisfied with the answer, he proceeded. At 9:39 p.m., he took command. Captain Schettino increased speed, but, realizing he was too close to the coast, ordered several turns to starboard. At times, the Indonesian helmsman had difficulty understanding. Just 4 minutes after Schettino had officially taken command, the 290-meter-long ship was just 450 meters from the rocks and headed for collision. But a 15-knot northeasterly wind reduced the effect by half. At 9:44 p.m., he ordered hard to starboard, pointing the ship out to sea. Then he ordered port 10, hoping that by pushing her left, it would take her around the rocks. He added hard to port, but incredibly, the first officer ordered the opposite. Schettino corrected him immediately, but it took 13 seconds for the rudders to adjust. 2 seconds later, the 51,000-ton ship smashed into the rocks.